civil servants, especially those in the low ranks like teachers, health workers and policemen, have often gone without salaries. But government has always offered lip service rather than practical solutions to the crisis.
Much as they are carrying out reforms, they should bear in mind that those who have not been paid should be paid in any way. Let the ministry see what it can do to ensure that the civil servants are paid. We've quoted an example of security people who carry guns and they are not being paid more than 3 months.
But we are going to work hand in hand with the district officials to make sure that the teachers should be paid. They should be paid because it is a big problem in my constituency.
I went to Mbara municipality and found a police constable who had not received his salary since December 2013.
Speaker Rebecca Kadaga last week directed Finance Minister Maria Kiwanuka to give a response to this persistent problem. But Kiwanuka's attempt to present a threadbare ministerial statement on the matter was treated with contempt by the lawmakers. She was forced to withdraw the statement and asked to bring a comprehensive one.
Poor minister seems not to be knowing the craftsmanship of what is happening. So that's why she brought a wrong document, and that's why Parliament has forced actually to withdraw and even apologize.
The document had so many discrepancies because it was giving wrong things. It was not a coordinated paper. I think the technocrats wrote for her something very bad.
As you know, we're only given one day to prepare it. So rather than come and say, oh, give us more time, I said, let me bring what I have. So they've duly noted. They have noted the successes and the challenges still remaining. They said, take it back and bring it when it's more complete.
Pay your workers their wages before their sweat dries. That would mean that before the end of the month, a civil servant must be paid.
The teachers were not paid, the police officers were not paid, the health workers were not paid, and this is some kind of escape goat. It's a mistake at the center which is being hidden. And the blame is transferred to the chief administrative officer. So we are just appealing to the ministry that if there is a mistake, if there is a weakness, they should correct it instead of blaming it on the innocent chief administrative officers.
Before she was forced to withdraw the statement, the minister told the MPs that he has now decentralized the payroll management system, which will enable public servants to get salaries in time. She revealed that as a result of the exercise to rid the payroll of ghosts, government has saved 9.6 billion shillings.
The police officers who are not paid demand more than the 9 billion shillings. They are being mistreated. The teachers from my constituency who are not paid are substantial.
We have cases of policemen. The policemen are there, but some of them have either been paid half the pay since March and April. All others have been totally missing out. So for you to say that you have made a saving is a misnomer.
So they are simply playing a ping pong. You cannot talk about a saving when actually you are withholding people's money, when you know that people have not been given a salary. So this is simply people's money. They even are actually supposed to be paying interest accruing.
The speaker has now sanctioned the House Select Committee to probe the issue of ghosts on the government payroll. Agnes Nandutu, NTV.